Although the Electric Island Festival usually happens in June, things like the COVID pandemic and Typhoon Nawang push back the event. But this year, coordinator Jia Wang is feeling pretty good.
The fact that we're bringing it back in June, during a time where it's peak summer, where a lot of the kids from the States, island kids from the States are back from college visiting, as well as Pride Month as well. So all of that combined together, it really makes what EIF is, you know, good vibe, good energy, good fun.
Guam's premier electronic music festival since 2013 has a lineup that is gonna be very interesting.
Making sure that it aligns with where a lot of people from Guam who are into the scene, you know, can actually follow. So I think one thing that we're gonna make it that we have challenged ourselves is that instead of just putting on a stage and, you know, just having a bar and all that, we're really looking to spruce up the venue. There's a lot of trees over here, so we're planning on putting a lot of uplights to really make this place look vibrant, along with really cool activities and engagements that we're planning with our vendors.
In the past, EIF has been held at the Guam Raceway Park and even Paseo. So why the Plaza de España this year?
This venue is beautiful. It's always been our dream and goal to actually do EIF on like grass, on turf. And so we just feel like the setting, the parking, and just the whole flow of this place is just really, really special.
You can get your tickets on guamtime.net or...
We are selling tickets at Hilton during our pop-up from Wednesday to Friday, 1 to 7 p.m. You can purchase them by cash at a small discount.
And for all of you that are still on the fence about checking it out...
Life is hard, right? We all have to work so hard, you know. We all have the responsibilities, and what EIF is a platform for people to come and let loose, right? We're not asking you or telling you to party every weekend, but I think once a year, everybody deserves it.
Celebrate at EIF. Jonagan Charfris, KM News.